YouTube, top of the morning. What's good with y'all? It's your man Gip, and I'm back with another video, back with another trucking vlog. It's early, guys. 6:30 a.m. Sunday morning. Currently, I got two loads booked leaving out of the port of Los Angeles. Turn around, probably about 60 miles one way, 60 miles back to the port. Go to the port, grab a loaded container, take it out of there, bring back an empty, repeat the process. But you can see what's going on. We got the hood up. And before you get to thinking anything crazy, no, we're not broke down. I don't got any crazy maintenance issues. But what we do got going on this morning is, I like to do a very thorough pre-trip inspection before I start the motor, especially when you got some used equipment, guys, or new. It's just a number of things that you want to go through. If you drive trucks or you're going to be getting into driving, this is something that you're going to be taught and something that you're going to have to do when you take your test to get your CDL. But my pre-trip inspection, what I like to do is, first and foremost, most definitely you want to check the oil. I like to give a twist and a tug on my drive shaft. This screw right here is what holds this bad boy in place. So whenever you need to like adjust your steering wheel, they would basically loosen this up, twist and turn this, get your steering wheel straight, then tighten this bolt. So you definitely will always want to make sure the bolt that's connected to your power steering equipment is always secure. It's not loose, not too much play in it. I like to keep my washer fluid full, you know, keep the windshield, keep your visibility up there nice and good. Airlines right here from this relay valve, you want to make sure nothing looks cracked or torn or anything. I always like to take a look down in my my brake chambers, take a look at my slack adjusters, and basically looking underneath the truck, looking for any signs of any oil or anything that would indicate any type of oil leaks or coolant leaks or any type of fluid leaking. Definitely want to make sure that your coolant level is sufficient and high. Mine's is basically at the minimum. I'm gonna go ahead and add some of that this morning. Gonna add a gallon of oil just to fill it up. I've been running real hard. Checked my dipstick already before we started the vlog. It's a little bit low, really don't need it, but it's better to be safe than be sorry. We're gonna add some coolant in here. And what really inspired me to start this vlog off right here in the engine bay, guys, is, let me show you guys something on the floor, on the ground, or should I say, you kind of see like, you can see like residue of a little markings right here and right here. They're really more so underneath the truck. Can't really see them because they kind of like dried up already. But last week I was coming out and I was noticing how it was a real little small, nothing too big, probably like that big around where it was indicating that I was leaking out some type of fluid. Ignored it the first day. When I seen it again the second day, I went on and climbed up under the truck to see if I could find out where it was actually coming from. I watched a video a few weeks ago, and a guy, he actually has a brand new Kenworth W900, and he was just giving some good information on pre-trips as well. So I got on my back, crawled all the way under here, scooted under here, because I basically wanted to get under there to see and be kind of like under the truck to be able to look up to see where the leak was coming from. Because more than likely when you have a leak, you go to checking your hoses, making sure your circle clamps is tight, looking for any signs of any leaks. So I got under there. At first I thought it was this hose right here, this coolant hose. Long story short, guys, it was leaking real minute from the actual coolant filter, which is right there. And then you got your white oil filters which are right there. So I got under there, man, and like I said, I was watching my man's video, and he was instructing you, like, sometimes, you know, these things, when you, they rattle, the vibration, they shake a lot, you're hitting a lot of bumps, that you want to just every so often check your filter. So I gave the thing a turn with my hand, and believe it or not, it turned with just my bare hand. I was like, bingo, that's it. Me and wife was out here trying to figure it out, because, you know, that's one thing you hate. Me, myself, I hate that. I like the engine to stay dry and be nice and dry. You shouldn't see any leaks under the truck. Not one drop. Everything should be staying inside of the engine component doing what it's supposed to do. Not leaking out on the ground. You feel me? So, got under there. Gave it a twist with my bare hand. It turned a little bit more. Grabbed these old leather gloves and twisted it even harder to tighten it up. Give it a little turn right now. Yeah, it's nice and firm in there. Basically, what I'm saying is, every so periodically, guys, make sure you check to make sure your oil filters, your fuel filters, your cooling filters is nice and snug. Especially after you get like an oil change or any PM service done to your truck. You want to make sure that your oil filters and any other filter is nice and secure, man. But let me go ahead and grab these oils out. We're gonna stuff you always want to keep in your truck anyway, man. What we got right here? Some of that good Shell Rotella 1540 weight. It's what's recommended for this motor. Got the 50-50 pre-diluted red, ready to use coolant. We're gonna add that, and I like to keep this in here, man. Keep the windshield clean. I also went out and bought a little tool. I want to have you a nice little tool bag at all times as well. Bought a little tool, you know, those little filter wrenches, little round circle, you clap it on there. You can keep all that stuff nice and tight, man. Let's get this cap off this coolant reservoir. Don't take that up to the max line. Definitely don't want to be dealing with no overheating with these heels and stuff. I've been climbing with these heavy containers. Took two of them out of there yesterday. First one wasn't too bad, about 25,000 pounds. But that second boy was 45,000. A lot of this stuff I learned, man, I just learned on myself and watching YouTube videos and just trying to stay on top of this motor and transmission and all my preventative maintenance stuff that I need to do, guys. Because this right here is the heartbeat of the truck and the whole business. If this ain't running right, these wheels ain't turning. If that fan and them fan bills and this motor and those injectors ain't pumping the correct way, this bad boy ain't gonna be bringing in a dime. So, here's what it is, man. Let's get these fluids in here. It's like feeding your baby a bottle, guys. Gotta feed your baby and keep them full of all the fluids they like. Got that one in. Let's get in with this oil. I don't have no funnel or anything like that, so I just normally like to start from the top. Pour slow. Don't need anything leaking out onto your engine. When your engine get hot, you'll be riding down the road smoking like a choo-choo train. Adding the Shell Rotella. Hear nothing but good things about it. I haven't went and did no major research on motor oil. They all pretty much do the same thing, but obviously this one here just has some added benefits for your motor. Volvo does have their own premium motor oil, but not making that trip over to the Volvo dealer just to get a gallon of oil when this Shell Rotella should be sufficient enough. This cooling reservoir hole is very small too, so it will be ideal to have a funnel. Got one in the truck, just don't feel like digging it out. Containers, it's not like it's a live load anyway. It's just a dropping hook. Drop the loaded, grab an empty, head back to the port. So I said, shit, it's my Sunday. Let me get started early. That way I can finish early and enjoy some of this beautiful weather that we've been having. Get this bad boy filled up, man. She may drink it all. She should drink it all. This is another formula of milk your baby likes. So we got that in there. Get this nice and tight, man. I remember one time I was somewhere. That's when I was taking this truck out over the road. I went into the hood to do a pre-trip inspection. My damn cap was missing to my coolant reservoir, so I got creative. Went in the truck stop market, bought a bag of chips, put it over here, put a rubber band around it to hold it in place. So as you can see, we up to the max line now. So yeah, man, without any further ado, hope I didn't bore you guys too much with this segment, but it's very important that you do your preventative maintenance.